Kyle Van Noy will have a new home in 2021. What's going on, Bottom Line viewers? It's Mitch here, here to give you the five landing spots for Kyle Van Noy this 2021 NFL free agency. The teams that I feel are the five best fits for linebacker slash edge player Kyle Van Noy, two-time Super Bowl champion, one of the smartest players at his position, and one of the most versatile playmakers at the edge spot. Here are five teams that I feel would be a perfect match for Kyle Van Noy's skill set. Before I give you those five matches for Kyle Van Noy, make sure that you do grok spike that like button, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more NFL on the Bottom Line View. NFL free agency 2021, make sure to subscribe. Kyle Van Noy, one of my favorite players in football, one of the most hybrid, versatile backers in the game. He can stand up, he can cover, he can blitz, he can rush off the edge, he can defend the run and set the edge. He is a two-time Super Bowl champion, and he will help an NFL team, whichever team he goes to, in 2021. In 2020, Kyle Van Noy had a career year, which is why it was so shocking to see Miami want to move on from him. He set career highs in tackles for a loss with 10. He had a career high, pass deflections, 6, 2 forced fumbles, 6 sacks on the year, 69 tackles, 28 pressures, 18 run stops in 14 games. Kyle Van Noy had maybe his best year of his career, and in 2019 and 2020, he's had his two best years of his career. So just getting to 30 years old now, which isn't that old, he is going to be a valuable piece to an NFL team, and you probably won't have to pay him top dollar like you did last year. So if you were a team that were interested in him last year, or maybe you were a team like New England who couldn't afford to bring him back, maybe, just maybe, you will be interested this offseason. Here are the five teams. Let's kick it off with the New England Patriots. Guys, I can't leave them out. I actually feel they are the top dog here. New England does have a need at the edge position. Of course, they lost Van Noy last offseason. They didn't have Dante Hightower last year, and they were missing Jamie Collins. They were without their three top linebackers from 2019 in 2020, and they suffered. Now, they do have Chase Winovich. They like Josh Uche, but I feel like they want to have a veteran presence to support those guys. Along with Dante Hightower coming back, Kyle Van Noy would fit the billing. He knows the system, obviously. He's a great fit within the system. He can do a lot of different things still at a very high level and is still at the peak of his powers. So Kyle Van Noy reuniting with Bill Belichick, it just makes too much sense. And that's probably why it might not happen. The number two team that I feel is a great destination for Kyle Van Noy is the New York Giants, because they have a New England coaching staff. Of course, Joe Judge, the head coach, but they also have layers of coaches on the defensive side of the football. They run a similar defensive, at least the foundation of that scheme, and they're looking for similar edge players like Kyle Van Noy. Not only could they use the skill set of Kyle, but they could also use the leadership for a team that's still trying to build that culture. The Giants are a fascinating team because they showed a lot of promise last year, surprised us in moments, but with a veteran like Kyle Van Noy only adding to the leadership and adding to the expertise and the IQ of that defense, an already pretty good defense, Kyle Van Noy could just add another great playmaker to that front seven. They desperately need edge players who can get to the quarterback, and Kyle Van Noy will be used correctly within that scheme. So I feel like it's a great fit for both Van Noy and for the Giants. The number three team that I feel is a fit for Kyle Van Noy is the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Now, this would only be if Shaq Barrett is not re-signed, but let's say Shaq Barrett is not re-signed. Tom Brady is going to give a call to Kyle Van Noy and be like, brother, come over, play for the Bucs, let's win another Super Bowl together, and that's going to be the end of the conversation, and Kyle Van Noy is going to play for Tampa Bay. Really, when you look at it, Todd Bowles' system, his scheme, he likes those stand-up edge rushers like Shaq Barrett. Kyle Van Noy is not as good as Shaq Barrett, obviously, as a pure pass rusher, but he's pretty similar in what they do and their skill set, in their size, in their profile. Van Noy can also give you a little bit more of a hybrid drop back and coverage kind of guy. He's still very good versus the run. He's just as smart as Shaq Barrett. So maybe you're losing a little bit of pass rushing prowess off the edge, but you get everything else that you get with Shaq Barrett in Kyle Van Noy. You also get a very experienced player that is used to playing in the playoffs and knows how to play big in those games. And of course, has a great relationship with the quarterback, Tom Brady. He would fit well in Todd Bowles' scheme, and I feel like if Shaq doesn't come back, Van Noy would be a nice budget option for the Bucs. The number four fit for Kyle Van Noy is the Baltimore Ravens. Why not put a winner on a team that wants to win? The Baltimore Ravens want to win right now. I feel like the appeal of Kyle Van Noy to them would be through the roof. When you look at what Van Noy can do from a skill set perspective and what Don Martindale's defense is, it's a perfect match. Van Noy is a hybrid backer edge player, kind of like, I don't know, Judon, Ngakoue, Bowser, who are all free agents who all might be on their way out seeking big money elsewhere. And Baltimore needs players that can play a similar role. And if not be better than those guys, that's Kyle Van Noy. He can defend the run well, set that edge. Baltimore is all about setting that edge. And he's crafty as a blitzer, incredibly smart, will pick up the defense just like that. Van Noy's a great fit for Baltimore. Brings that edge that you like in a Raven defender, brings that cockiness, that swagger. You love to see it. I feel like it's a perfect fit. Van Noy in Baltimore. Don't sleep on that one. The final destination for Kyle Van Noy is to join Mike Vrabel in Tennessee with the Titans. When you really think about it, Mike Vrabel, Kyle Van Noy, kind of the same player. So Mike Vrabel would truly understand how to utilize Kyle Van Noy. Whether it's an inside or outside linebacker, the Titans need players like that. Jayon Brown is a free agent. Jadeveon Clowney is a free agent. They really don't have a great pass rush as it stands. They love to utilize these type of athletes. Van Noy would be a perfect fit. He would also bring a player with, of course, that experience, the winning pedigree that Vrabel's looking for, the toughness, the edge, the cockiness, all of that stuff that Van Noy brings that I feel would be perfect for Tennessee, that Titans culture. Many Patriot players of the past have played in Tennessee and had some success there, like Logan Ryan, for example. I feel Van Noy, Tennessee, another team that could be back in the playoffs, he's going to want to go to one of those teams, go to a good culture because he understands what good culture is, and the Titans are another team that have that. So there you go, my top five destinations for Kyle Van Noy. All teams with Patriot-like ties or a scheme that I feel would best fit Kyle Van Noy. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, make sure you do gronk spike that like button and don't forget to subscribe for more NFL free agency. Where do you think Kyle Van Noy will land? Peace.